What is up, guys? We are back with another wonderful video. Today we are going to be doing a little robocraft. Hope you guys enjoy it. Now the game was recently updated. They added a couple new things. For those who don't know about the new items that were added, for most of what you can see, the way to edit your robot is now different. The now added it so that instead of you having Robux and Galactic coins, they've changed it down now to Robits, just Robits. And you can take items that you gain from crates that they now allow you to purchase and make and turn those into Robits, depending on what you're forging or what you're recycling. Depends on how much, because when you forge something it's twice as much, but when you're recycling it's only half. So it's like those are like probably about the same with the base weapons, but they won't let you sell the base weapons, which is a problem. They've also changed it so that originally in the original game it was the blocks were these were different levels. Some were higher, some were lower, but now they've made it so that these are no longer higher or lower. They are the same. Alright, now, the social channel has remained the same. Nothing much has changed yet. I do believe they are eventually going to be adding clans, as you could see. That's a new interesting thing they have yet to add. Leagues also, it's probably still the same since the last I checked. But now they've also added cooler robots to the factory. I think the factory is also sort of new in between the cross updates. They've also added it so you can purchase robots now. You can sell your robots and it will come out here. If you press the show my bots button, it will give you what you have to sell. The more expensive ones I have are because it's just got a bunch of things on it. The cheapest one is actually just a shell, but these things are not cheap. They've also added a couple new game modes. Originally, it was Team Deathmatch, which was you kill people, they don't respawn. Once all the teams eliminated, that other team wins. Pit was the original. That hasn't changed. Battle Arena hasn't changed. But AI is new. Elimination mode has been brought, is now what was Team Deathmatch originally. Team Deathmatch is now also a new game mode as well. They've brought it so that now when you shoot someone and kill them, they can respawn in regular mode. Testing is also been brought in recently. Not this update, but a couple updates ago they brought that in as well. And they've also made it so now you have to go into a completely different mode to edit your robot. And they've also, for the noobs, they provided you with a tutorial mode. I think they just basically give you a bot and teach you everything about the game, which would be pretty cool, you know. I mean, the fact that they don't normally do that. So, now I'm going to decide between one of my bots. I'm probably gonna go with this one. And this is the one of the bots that you see featured on the store. This is the 213,000 bot. This one's the cheaper one here. It's a little more, it's more squared out now because I was working on making it so that you can stack wings. Oh, now I see why that looks off. As you can see, it swaps you right into a new edit mode. But the buttons have changed, so instead of you pressing F to change what to select whatever you're looking at, it now becomes the middle scroll wheel. You press the middle scroll wheel, it will select the block. Did I just? Oh yeah, and X also does that as well. So for those who wanted to do something instead of it being F, F is now forge, but middle scroll wheel helps to be better because X is all the way, way down there. Now, this is the world-renowned agile. Because A, the power output of this is crazy. It's got 5 cheetah thrusters, which is the most powerful thrusters there are on this bad boy. And those 5 thrusters are evenly placed so that the front weighs a little more than the back, because you don't want the front to weigh less, because then that front will just keep going up. And you won't go forward, it will just push air instead of going through the air. Now, I think I might take this one for a spin today. Yeah, I'm going to take this one for a spin. Now that I've fixed it up, I want to be... I want to play this one. Eventually, I'm going to save up enough money to... enough robots, that is, to work a better bot. But right now, this one needs to be worked on a little bit. Aeroflight cannons are definitely worth the while, but they're not worth it if you buy just Aeroflex, because then you shoot at people who aren't air-related, and their effects do not work the same. They just hit instead. Aeroflex are more meant for air. So, for those who decide to go completely Aeroflex, be careful. Duly note, the names are different colors for me and the wonderful Fortune player, because that is not hacked. It is literally the easiest thing on the planet, and that is called color coding. If you look it up on RoboCraft forums, it will tell you what numbers you have to do. Normally, it's something stupid like square bracket 00. FFOO, meaning zeros. They don't want you. It's coding, so of course it's going to be zeros. Okay, we're not moving as normal. Okay, we are not having a good day today. As you can see, we are not having... You know, now I'm really pissed off, because that's a dinghy of a robot. Of course, I was down to only one thing.
You're still working on the app? Eden? Are you still working on the app? Or you can't even hear me? Can you hear me? Let me test my mic.
I can hear
you. I think you can hear me.
He's just not talking right now.
Oh, okay.
He's just being...
Your voice is similar to his. Well, is he working in the app or so?
I don't know. Excellent question. Wish I knew.
He told me that earlier. So for now, I'll have to go. I may be back in like 15 minutes or so. Just let him know when he's back on.
Wow. Okay.
Don't shut up now. See ya.
I hate people at this. This is why you don't play a flyer against most people. Ow. Whoa. You know. You know what? Go to hell, all of you.
What?
I'm yelling at the bots because I literally go to kill one person and there's 17 people
in
one
spot. I have to go for a little bit.
Good. Please go. Please leave me. So I cannot snap at you for no reason. And there's also another problem. Someone needs to report to RoboCraft themselves that their game is cracked because it will not allow you to warp yourself out of that. You should be able to use yours. Will not let you get out of harm's way. Fuck your ass, because you don't have the balls to fucking fight me. You got 3 guns, and those 3 guns do nothing. Go fuck yourself for camping like a little bitch on hovers. Meet the people who you don't want to fight. Because they don't have courage. They don't have the will. They also don't have the power. Apparently, I don't have enough to move altogether. Not a single kill, but a million deaths, because this is why you don't play flyers. They don't work. Okay. You play one game with a good flyer, you still don't get anywhere. Because the plasmas and lasers from the ground will knock you. You get no luck. You get nothing whatsoever. It's all terribleness. That was a luck chance there. I did not see that one coming. To be honest with you, I didn't even think that was coming. Alright, that gives me a throw off for there. But I need to have one more for that. So, let's get to playing, I would hope for. First off, I'm gonna edit this one real quick. I love this one. And I'm going to So, now, to all those people who are just ready to play this game, be very careful, because people with high levels tend to have more powerful weapons, and you will once in a while run into someone who is a very high level who will not be merciless. I mean, they are not nice people when it comes down to it. I should play this robot more, but you know, I don't have all the weapons I need for it. I'm gonna borrow some weapons from my world-renowned robot. Alright, let's go edit this one. This bot is my dangerous one. Oh, wait, there was one thing I had to do. That's what you gotta be able to defend yourself from above. If necessary, my robot will be able to go higher than most of them. Alright, so. Now that that's better set up, this is my lovely Osprey. If anyone were to see it, they would be running away from it. Because quite honestly, this thing is actually very powerful and very hard to hit. The Agile, as you can see, one who knows how to use it, quite honestly, would be dangerous with it. So, one word to the wise. Using a flyer, be careful. They might know how to use it very well. Alright, so now that I've completed that, we are going to do a little league. You have to be a maximum of 1,000. But don't worry, a maximum of 1,000 comes easily when you get better weapons. Me, I don't have all my buffs to 1,000 quite yet because I have been working with whatnot, like the smaller bots, to try and get better weapons for them. So far, as you can see, that has been working. It is on 9,000. I'm working 900. I'm working on getting 2,000, but the 1,000 will.
The battle for Ophiuchus Valley has begun.
Ah, nice. Swag.
The little fusion tower has been captured. Your team has captured the bottom fusion tower. Your fusion shield is now active. Your team has captured the top fusion tower. Clock cycle booster activated. Your bottom fusion tower is under attack. Your bottom fusion tower is under attack. Your top fusion tower is under attack. Your bottom fusion tower is under attack. Bottom fusion tower is under attack.
Wow.
Your bottom fusion
and
tower
then you
is
see
under
why
attack.
There's a problem. Because there's people like this who need to go to hell and they need to suffer. Because we suffer, and we are victorious.
Your Your bottom fusion tower is under attack. Top fusion tower is under attack. You have captured the enemy's middle fusion tower. Your enemy's fusion shield has been deactivated. Your bottom fusion tower is under attack. 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 Your bottom fusion tower has been captured.
Okay, I'm taking this shield out because these guys are annoying me. The little bitches that float. Do warn. Sorry for those who are not quite able to handle language, but I don't know why they put it on non-restricted, because you really should be restricted. It's not okay to be in a channel like this.
Your middle fusion tower is under
attack. So your discretion is advised. Even though they don't set the channel to be your discretion. You know that, but hell of a reason they don't.
Your middle fusion tower is under attack. Your middle fusion tower has been captured. You no longer have your clock cycle booster. You have captured the enemy's bottom fusion tower. Clock cycle booster activated. Your top fusion tower is under attack. Your top fusion tower is under attack. Your top fusion tower is under attack. Middle fusion tower. Your enemy's fusion shields have been deactivated. Your top fusion tower is under attack.
Yeah, exactly. Thank you.
top fusion tower is under attack. Your top fusion tower has been captured.
Son of a bitch. Wow, you're a fucking camper. That is retarded as fuck. So far, three deaths.
You have captured the enemy's fusion tower. Your enemy's fusion shield has been deactivated. Your middle fusion tower is under attack.
That's gonna be that left side.
Your middle fusion tower is under attack.
You notice who's shooting at me? Not the guys on the ground. The air idiots that don't get that they're going to get beaten to a pulp by the ground units. Because they haven't realized
under attack.
And they realize that then they're going to really be in for a fun fight because they're going to die.
Your plutonium reactor is under attack. Your top fusion tower is under attack. Your plutonium reactor is under attack. Your top fusion tower is under attack. Your top fusion tower is under attack. The enemy plutonium crystal is nearly destroyed. Your top fusion tower is under attack.
I think I did the most amount of damage, that team victory. I did the least amount of damage, actually. Other than Pooh, who did nothing. He did literally... nothing. Everyone else did at least 6,000 damage. I did nothing. Which is kind of sad. I got 2 kills though, which is good. Better than none. Definitely would not have been a game changer, would be me. Hey, I got the only rare. Hey. Gain a star. Yes! That's one. You're saving up 10k.
The battle for Spitzer Dam has begun. Your team has captured the middle fusion tower. Your fusion shield is now active. Your team has captured the bottom fusion tower. Clock cycle booster activated. Spotted. 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 Your bottom fusion tower is under attack.
I can't do anything.
Your bottom fusion tower is under attack.
That person is an instant one kill person. You can't hit something like that.
Spotted. Spotted. Your bottom fusion tower is under attack. Your middle fusion tower is under attack. Spotted. Spotted. Your bottom fusion tower is under attack. Spotted. Your middle fusion tower is under attack. Spotted. Your bottom fusion tower is under attack. Your middle fusion tower is under attack. Spotted. Bottom fusion tower is under attack. Spotted. Spotted. Spotted.
Well.
Spotted.
In the hole in the bowl in the bottom of the hole.
Your
in the
bottom fusion tower is under attack.
Thank you. Let's go.
Spotted. Your bottom fusion tower has been captured. You no longer have your clock cycle booster.
Oh, I see how it is.
Thank you.
How is it the rockets, when they hit the earth, don't explode? They're supposed to explode, not go through a mountain cliff. Spotted.
Spotted. Spotted.
Why do I even bother in this game anymore? I know I'm just gonna get shut up by the friggin' kid who's 8-2.
Your middle fusion tower is under attack. Spotted.
That thing's pretty sick.
Your middle fusion tower is under attack. Your middle fusion tower has been captured. Your fusion shield has been deactivated. Spotted. Your plutonium reactor is under attack. Spotted.
Why am I automatically the target for everything? You know? And they won't even let you quit the game even if you get killed, so do not play this game. Scratch that. No one play this game. Because do you see why I complain? Do you see why I complain? This is the problem. These people are the problem. Meet the problem and how it's not handled. Robocraft, get your shit together. We need to buffer this game dramatically. Really, buffer the damn game, Robocraft. Because I swear, notice what is the problem. Those rocket launchers are too overpowered.
Your middle fusion tower is under attack. You have captured the enemy bottom fusion tower.
Enemy automatically leaves.
Your middle fusion tower has been captured. You no longer have your clock cycle booster. Spotted. Your bottom fusion tower is under attack. Spotted. 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 Your bottom fusion tower is under attack. Your bottom fusion tower has been captured. Your fusion shield has been deactivated. Spotted.
The only time you will see me leave a battle is because of stupid shit like this. Only time. Because I do not like people who are terrible like that. It's like you just get purposely put into a team that has nothing. Nothing at all. And has no way of doing anything. There's no balance. There's no even. This game is not evenly balanced.
That's the one thing they haven't figured out, is how to balance a game properly. Never play this game. I am sorry. I really don't want people to be bad. Like, that mad. Because this game's not balanced. It's not fair. And to be honest with you, the developers have yet to do something smart. Other than make it so that something's really overpowered. And then when it gets really buffed out, then they make it so that it gets put against something that has not a single chance. Like, and knowing most of the time, that's going to be someone with a flyer. Because rocket launchers can't do anything much than hit flyers. I mean, really, honestly. It's not worth wasting your time. Or your money. I've wasted money on it. That's how I got to 108. But I'm actually pretty good. But it's ridiculous right now. Because, to be honest with you, these robots are great. They're fun to play with. But the people aren't. People in this game are dicks. They don't know how to do anything. And, to be honest with you, I like this game a lot, but I don't like the people in it. It's a great recommendable game. But I recommend, if you play it, be at your own risk. Because, to be honest, I had to calm down for a minute. Because that was really annoying. And, to be honest, I'm pretty sure a lot of you would have agreed. Because it's like, it aggravates you so much to know that there's that one person.
It's just so aggravating.
Alright, now I'm actually gonna play a game where I actually know is fair. I'm gonna play on this robot of mine. It is very evenly balanced. This one's 872. Thanks to the boost from that extra flag I added on in the back there. I need to get more weapons for it. But I don't have the money for that right now. So I will earn them in a team deathmatch round. Not recommending playing League unless you have the courage. I had courage and also the audacity to get smacked across the face. By 7 different people. And you know what? It pisses me off. Because I don't like people who, speaking of which, chat, notice, the most extremely racist people come out of nowhere and start yelling racist things. That's a downside. Don't know where that comes from. I have not seen that yet. But I do know, for a fact, that if you know exactly what to build and how to build it, it'll go your way. Well, I probably picked the wrong bot for the day. But this game might go according to plan for once. I am using Tornado Hover Blade. And then he's gonna get healed back. You see what the dilemma is here. There's people who are the dumbest things on the planet. I mean, like, they're dumber than a brick. And yet, they survive. Don't run away, because you're not getting help this time. That was my revenge. Yeah, and you automatically heal. You just gotta be very careful with how fast you heal. Because you will heal, but not very fast. Jägerman Meister. And you notice, you're about to get smacked. Ow. And you see, that's the dumbest thing to do. Go all of these laser rail cannons. It's a really bad idea. I give you personal advice. Don't go all lasers. Or all rail cannons. Go a cross combo. Because then if you see something from a distance... Look at that guy, he's coming to me. No one picked him up. And you notice, the only way I die, everyone working together. Really? That's really gonna annoy me that a little laser bot's gonna do that much damage. Spotted. He doesn't Spotted. Even have enough rail cannons to really hit me. Spotted. An awesome rail cannon. Demobilize. Why are you guys aiming at the ground again? Of course I'm gonna hit that, because there's apparently a hill here. You are asking for a butt kicking. Because you are the most annoying little, quite weirdly shaped like a Kakuna helicopter. Did anyone else notice that? If you did, do send me a comment, because I do think that it's a little weird that helicopter looks like a Kakuna. Or even a Metapod. Duly note, though, protect your teammates. There might be your best opportunity. See, as like I told you, Rife isn't a bad opportunity there. Backing him off my teammate would be a good idea. Just
You notice, it's three of them. Not just one, not just two, but three. This is why when you go into a battle, you bring 10 of them. Because then you start losing because you don't have enough firepower to really win. Sounds like there's something going on over here.
Spotted.
Yeah, they're going for Rife. Of course they are. Wow. No. No. That is bull. That is bull. Do you see the reason I get mad? Because of stupid things that don't even happen ever in a game. Except when you have to deal with that. I mean, seriously. You go from a winning standpoint to a losing standpoint. Just because someone looks like a freaking caterpillar and decides he's gonna be good. No. That's not how you play a game. You don't look like a freaking caterpillar because that doesn't do anything other than give you a little bit more shield. Shield doesn't matter. It's power that does. If you can kill someone even with shields, that means you got enough power to rule the game. You don't need shield if you have power. And I have power. And I don't need shield. Oh. Now. You come over to the cube recycler. I don't really give a fuck about that. What did I just get? Oh, top laser heart. Yeah, I didn't need that. Or that. Alright. As you can see, these are very meager. You need legendary or epics to get anything really good priced. Alright. Let's go kill someone. Because as you can see, we started out great. Now, this is gonna
team
be
death
fun.
Match. Kill
I
the enemy team to win. The first team to reach the target total wins.
Okay.
Spotted.
Yep. That's me. That's me right there, that flying thing. I just realized that's our entire enemy team.
There's the bug. That's what you need to take care of. Is stupid things like that. They build quadcopters and think they're cool. Buy a quadcopter. Don't build it. Spotted. Don't waste your time in a game to build something that makes zero sense on. Although that guy right there. I am your worst freaking nightmare. You are not staying afloat. I'm going to find you, and when I do, I'm going to kill you. And when I kill you, you'll be the last time you see anything. Because I can look straight up and shoot. Nothing can be done about it. This one. Oh yeah, we're gonna have a showdown right now. That's how I'm doing. This is how I'm rolling. This is how I'm killing. This is how I'm shredding. You guys are shredding nothing. You are not even shredding a fiber of anyone's soul. Now, it would be good to be a walker, but you know, walkers are so hard to come by. Hovers, you could do just about the same. To be very careful with how far you push it. Now, he, on the other hand, is pushing it a little too far. You notice they go to hide on the opposite side. Where am I getting shot from? Because the last I checked, there's no one shooting. Wow, you got a grudge problem? Well, you are now going to die again because you have a grudge problem. Well, that's gonna like, really? You should know better than to go into the enemy spawn when you're losing. There should be no way I died from something that small and annoying. Meanwhile, there will be no reason I'm dying from something that small and annoying. We don't lose. Even when you only get 2 kills, we don't lose. That's just it. Even if you do the least amount of damage, you still did better than the other team. If they lost, there's a problem. There's seriously a problem. And well, God, you better hope that there is. Huh. Yeah. Guess that would've been cool, but you know. Just common, uncommon, rare, epic, legendary. Thank you. Okay, that's all I really have to show. Because I can't see all the lower ranks. Yeah, these struts are actually pretty good for wings if you use them right. These can be thrown up into an arc like dumb nice helicopters, eh? What I need is weapons. Forget to bring another thing. I should dismantle and sell one bot. Hold on. Just to be honest. I want this one. And you know. Because I can. Upload and just. That'll put on a different box. Show no mercy. Show no mercy. Show no mercy. Well, that sells out wonderfully. That was one entire box worth of recycling. I wish I had enough to afford one of these. Laser Leviathans. Without the carbon 6 ability. But they're 100,000+. Afford proto seekers finally, but I want that chain shredder. I'll drop a couple guns. That's 30,000 if I recycle these. Jesus. I have 39,000 now. None of these are able to be purchased because they need to really buff it more. Because, A, I can understand this being expensive, but, like, things like the Leviathan should be lowered price. Because this is only 6,000. And you go from 6,000 to 100,000. It shouldn't be like that. It should be 6,000. Like, 10,000. 90,000 kind of thing. Like, make the rare stuff, like the harder to come by stuff, other than these things. Because even if it's legendary, that doesn't mean go millions of dollars expensive. I mean, like, this one could be like 80,000, 70,000, and it would be fine. But it's just not, which is the problem. And if you had electro shields would be great. So, I'm gonna try and save up for that. Hope for the best. Because I could buy something really cool. That just gives you it. The full forge would just mean. Definitely a waste of money. It's a great starter bot, but it's not worth the purchase if you are a regular person. If you notice, chain guns are actually pretty sweet. Also highly expensive, so it makes it harder to come by. Overwolf claw question mark? Like, he built the entire thing overwolf related and then stopped. Yeah, shielded bot would be nice. For only one gun. It is semi-easy to come by. This is what I was thinking. You see these things and it's just like, yas. But you also know that it's retarded as hell. But this one actually not bad. I'll give them that. This barrel spins so fast. If you notice the chain gun ammo, fling, that thing is loading two buckets of ammo. It's pretty funny. See, people get smart though. They build things that work. And this does, in fact, work. You throw wasps on for no reason. Man, what I would do to have a chain gun. That's just stupid. It's just an individual plunk. Give you props for trying, but you know, Mitch-tastic. I can't believe he's on one. Now there's a tech worth purchasing. I would have scrapped the carbon 6 running on the side, but this tank looks nice. Cuts in perfectly for what you need. I would have, instead of doing those round triangles, I would have just done the flat ones, give it a little more angle, give it a prop out more. And you notice the tank shreds are probably... As you can see, I am so poor, it's not even funny. So, I'm just gonna, you know, sit and wait and play and hope to get 100-something thousand fast. If I were to get a chain gun from a crate, that would be crazy. You gotta get higher levels though to get higher crates, and to get higher crates costs money if you wanted to absolutely do that. Cost quite a bit. Alright. So, we're now just waiting on finally. Because all you can hear is dick, drip, dwip, dwip, dwip. That's getting out of the way.
This is Team Deathmatch. Kill the enemy team to win. The first team to reach the target total wins.
Alright. Here we go.
Spotted. Spotted.
Sliding to the left. No one think to do something that stupid, pure like. You sit there and they won't do much to you. So, let's go. go kick some butt. Since I'm only level 1, I believe. Or probably a 3, I can't tell. They're all rail cannons, which is really going to be funny. Because they can't do much. They all run away. They can't face the fact that they're gonna get hit and killed. That was the weirdest end sequence on the planet. Pretty weird end sequence. Ooh. Rare. Pretty neat. Nice, decent rare. Is some good recycling there. That's 40,000. I'm gonna figure out somewhere to put this. To be honest with you, it's nice to have something this cool. There we go. Actually, it sits nicely on the back end of it. And it provides a little more cover to the ass end of it. I should figure out a way to stack it on nicely, but you know. Alright, so I think that was a pretty good day for a game sesh, and it went pretty well. So, I mean, get 1-2, lost 2, gain this game, lose that, you know, decisions were made. So, in all honesty, it's pretty neat. Duly note that Broken Gamer's gear is available for the Broken Gamer's Twitch channel. That will be available soon. We are working on the logo now. And Legends vs. Gaming gear, I have to work that with the other team as well for that. But duly note, it is available soon. Thanks for watching, guys.